Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is Equations of Circles, Part 4. In this video, we define the standard form of a circle and the general form of a circle, and we do the following two problems. All right, in the previous videos, we've been working with what is called the standard form of a circle. X minus h squared plus y minus k squared equals r squared. This is the standard form because it's easy to tell what the center of the circle is. It'll be hk, and what the radius of the circle is. So this is the preferred form, basically, especially if you want to sketch the circle. But if you take an equation in that form and you multiply it out and simplify the left side, set it equal to zero, we get what's called the general form of a circle, which looks like this. X squared plus y squared plus ax plus by plus c equals zero. A, b, and c are just some constants. You know, it might be they a could be zero or b could be zero, c might be zero, but not all three of them. If all three numbers are zero, right, of those constants, A, B, and C, you're not going to get a circle. So as long as that's not true, we're going to get a circle. So notice you have an x squared term, a y squared term, and then you might have an x and a y term and a constant. All right, so what we're going to do is learn how to go back and forth between the two. Going from standard to general is a lot easier than going the other way around. So we'll start with that. Here's our problem. State the center and radius of the equation of the circle given in standard form, then write the equation of the circle in general form. So here's our equation. X minus 2 squared plus y plus 5 squared equals 10. All right, so I want you to write down what the center and the radius is. All right. So the center of the circle, all right, what's the x coordinate going to be? It's going to be 2. Remember, it's the opposite. So instead of minus 2, it's positive 2. And we have y plus 5, so that'll be a negative 5. Right? So hopefully you got 2 and negative 5. If you're not sure, I'll tell you an easy way to do it. Take what's in the parentheses and set it equal to 0, and that'll tell you your x coordinate. And then take what's in parentheses with a y and set it equal to 0, that'll give you your y coordinate. So for instance, if you did y plus 5 equals 0, you get y equals negative 5. But that's not y, that's the k, right? It's the y coordinate. All right, and what about the radius? All right, this is not in the form r squared, but remember that means that r squared is 10. So r, now when you take the square root, you normally put plus or minus 10, but remember this is a length, so it's just the square root of 10. So the radius is square root of 10. So that's the center and the radius of this circle. And if you wanted to draw it, you would have to approximate square root of 10, right? It's a little bit bigger than 3, right? You'd have to find the center where 2, negative 5 is, right? That order pair, and then you would go to the right a little over 3, and a little over 3 to the left, a little up, and a little down. Okay, but the directions that are here are not to graph it, which you could do, but it's to write the equation of the circle in general form. So we take this equation. And we need to multiply it all out, set it equal to zero, and then we'll have general form. So why don't you try that on your own? All right, so let's do this. So we have x minus 2 times x minus 2. So remember that's going to be x squared minus 4x plus 4. Don't forget the middle term. And a y plus 5 squared, remember that's y plus 5 times y plus 5. Now, if you need to do that on the side, go ahead and do that, or right here. I'm just skipping showing all those steps and using the formula, which is the first squared plus 2 times the y times the 5, that's how I get 10y, plus the last term squared. All right, so oops, that was supposed to be y squared. And then now to get it in general form, what we want to do is we want to put the x squared term first, and then we want to put the y squared term second. Then we want to put the x term, which is negative 4x. And then we want to put the y term, which is 10y. Now we're going to add the constants. 4 plus 25 is 29. All right. And then notice how this says equals 10. I'm going to subtract that 10 from both sides to finish the problem. So we have x squared plus y squared minus 4x plus 10y. If I subtract 10 from both sides, I have plus 19 equals 0. And that is the general form. It's general because it's not so obvious. It's a circle when you first look at it. It is because you've got an x squared plus a y squared term, but you can't tell the center and the radius in this form. So now we're going to go backwards. What if I gave you this equation? Now I know the answer. I know the center is 2, negative 5, and the radius is square root of 10. The question is, how would you figure that out? So we're going to start with this equation and see if we can get it back to the standard form so that we could tell what the center and radius is. To do this, you have to remember how to complete the square. If you need a review of completing the square, see my videos on completing the square. All right, so we have this equation. The directions are write the equation in standard form. Now, once you write it in standard form, you should be able to pick out what the center and the radius of the circle is. That's why it's important to know how to write it in standard form. But if you're given this form, what do? Well, you're going to put the two x terms together, the x squared term and the negative 4x. So I'm going to write the x squared minus 4x, and I'm going to use the idea of completing the square. So I'm going to put plus a blank here. I'm going to have to figure out what to add to that to make this a perfect square. And I'm going to put the y squared terms together. So I put the y squared term and the y, and I'm going to put a blank. Okay, I know I'm going to have to add something to complete that square. I think I need a little more space. Okay. And then check out what I'm going to do. I'm going to have to make this a lot smaller. On a regular piece of paper, you got a lot more room than on this little screen. I'm going to put the negative 19 on the other side. Are you with me there? Okay, so I've got the x squared, I've got all the rest of the terms. The x squared, the y squared, the negative 4x, the plus 10y are on the left-hand side. I'm going to subtract 19 from both sides. And I know I'm going to add two more terms. Now, I don't have room still. I'm going to add two more terms. Whatever I add here and whatever I add here. And these are going to be constants. Here's where the completing the square comes in. Okay, so I want to write each of these as something completing the square. All right, so how do I do that? X squared minus 4x plus what? All right, so remember how you do that? This is going to have to be an x. This is a minus sign. And what do? We take half of the coefficient here. So the coefficient, well, it's really a negative 4, so it's going to be a minus 2. Or since I already put the minus sign, I just put the 2 here. What then would have been up there on that blank? 2 squared. So 4 is what I have to add to both sides. And notice if I add it to the left side of the equation, I have to add it to the right side of the equation. Okay, we'll just do the same thing with a y. This will have to be a y plus half the coefficient would be 5, right? Half of 10 is 5. So what would have been up here to make this a perfect square? In other words, y plus 5 squared, the constant term would be 5 squared or 25. Let's do that in red to make it stand out. And add 25 to both sides. Don't just add it to the left side, add it to both sides. So what do I really end up with on the right-hand side? I had the negative 19 plus 4 plus 25. So what does that add up to? That adds up to 10. By the way, if it's a circle, it has to be a positive number. If you get a negative number, it's not going to be a circle. You can't have a circle with a negative radius. So we have just, by completing the square, rewritten this in standard form, and that was the exact thing you saw on the previous page when I gave it to you there. Here it is, see? X minus 2 squared plus y plus 5 squared equals 10. We put it in this general form. Now I gave it to you in general form. Use completing the square to put it in standard form. Now that it's in standard form, if you wanted, you could tell me what the center is, which will be 2, negative 5. You could look at it, figure out the radius would be what? Square root of 10. I think we already figured that out in the previous problem. And then if you wanted, you could graph it. So what we're working on here is taking something in general form, completing the square so that we could figure out what the center and radius is. All right, so we're completing the square to put it in standard form, right? This was general. Complete the square to put it in standard, because once it's in standard, easy to see what the center and the radius is. So we'll do some more problems like this on the next video and beyond, and some more, other interesting questions that you might be asked if you're working with circles and equations. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.